Monsieur le Marquis.
I'm listening, Aegis.
Monsieur le Marquis, there is a most unfortunate rumor about you going round.
Oh, just one, is there?
You are accused of having delivered the troops who had gathered in the Place Dauphine over to the king.
Calumny. This is nothing less than vile slander.
Save your breath, General. The rumor is true. I can prove it. There's no point in trying to defend yourself. I know that you raised the National Guard for the sole purpose of taking command of it. There was nothing spontaneous about the uprising.
Do you have any evidence to support your accusations?
I do. I have the manifesto.
Bon sang.
Why resort to this manipulation?
You must understand what I have done. I did for the good of the kingdom. I wanted to stop this massacre while protecting the Queen and the Dauphin. In the name of the people, Aegis. But an actual uprising of the people would have inevitably led to disaster. Only professional soldiers could organize and lead the resistance.
Who were your accomplices?
My brothers in arms. The brave men of the Régiment de Saint-Onge. Veterans of the American War. Men who at the Battle of Yorktown brought an empire to its knees. Alas, we gravely underestimated the enemy's forces. We thought we would face an infantry supported by a handful of machines, but an entire army of automats. It was unthinkable.
Some accuse you of harboring a lust for power. The circumstances were to your advantage.
These aspersions are all too familiar to me. But tell me, if I wanted the crown for myself, why did I not take it when I returned from America? When I had seasoned troops at my command and the people sang my praises with one voice? No, that makes no sense. Though I readily admit that I do believe I am worthy of fulfilling an important role for the Queen after her son is crowned. Lieutenant General of the Kingdom, for example. Or even, if circumstance requires, the Regent. Voila. Now you know everything. I haven't left anything out. However, this truth, if it were made public, would play right into my enemy's hands. So I ask you not to reveal anything I've just told you. And to give me the manifesto.
C'est entendu, General. Here.
Aegis, by doing this, you're not saving my honor. You're saving the future of the entire kingdom. Oh, and one more thing. Can you tell me where I can find my detractor? The one who told you the rumors about me?
I cannot tell you anything, General.
Oh. No matter. I will not let this serpent continue to vilify me. I shall get redress for these aspersions in the end.
Do as you wish, General de Lafayette. General, there is an alarming rumor about you going around.
Huh. Just one, is there?
You are accused of having delivered the troops who had gathered in the Place Dauphine of...
Calumny. I am the... What's more, this was the work... It was only a mess. But tell me.
From Marat.
Marat. It's always Marat. Nothing can stop that swinish mudslinger from slandering the most upstanding subjects in the kingdom. Ah, if I had gotten hold of him, I would have ensured he loses taste for gossip, believe you me. Me. Throwing the people to the wolves. What a foul accusation. I see the Duke d'Orléans' hand in this. A prince without a kingdom, but a master in the art of treachery. From exile, the wretch will stop at nothing to bring down the dynasty. He would go so far as to do away with the queen and her children, but I don't intend to let it happen. The day is fast approaching when I will make him pay.
Goodbye, Monsieur le Marquis. Monsieur Marat.
Madame?
I'm surprised to find you here. Did you follow me?
Didn't you know? The Duke's allies are always impeccably informed. Some even say that we have eyes and ears everywhere.
What do you want from me?
To tell you the truth, I can't wait to hear what you've discovered about the matter at hand. And I was afraid you might leave me in the lurch. You can never be too cautious these days. That's why I decided it would be better for me to come to you.
You were right. Lafayette was behind this purportedly popular uprising.
Aha! I've got him at last.
But he had no intention of handing his men over to the king. His goal was to raise an army and command the troops himself.
It doesn't matter. These troops would have allowed him to crush the patriots and set himself up as a dictator. He lied to the people. He lied to the Assemblée Nationale. His time has come. All I need is for you to give me the proof of his treason.
I have no proof, monsieur. You will have to be satisfied with my word.
Your word? What good is your word to me? Do you think I can convince people by repeating baseless accusations? Believe me, I have tried, but without much success. No, it's useless. I must admit defeat. We will have either the king or Lafayette, one despot or another. In either case, my fate is sealed. I will soon join the Duke in exile, and I will abandon my beloved people to their doom. I have no other choice.
If I take one more step, there will be no turning back. This path will lead me straight to the Quartier du Temple. There's no turning back. From now on, I will have to do without a carriage. The Bastille is to the south of the Temple.
Thank you.
The Bastille's cannons destroyed the square. What a ghastly massacre. It seems that the artillerymen used Monsieur Leclos' devastating cannonballs. What are you blaming yourself for, monsieur?
No. Get back! Assassin!
I'm not your enemy. My only aim is to defeat the royal army.
Why should I believe you? It's true that you can speak. Maybe you're truly not one of them.
Dites-moi, what is this chaos? What disaster has befallen the Place Royale?
That's where we, loyal patriots, had gathered. A band of brave souls armed with what paltry weapons we could find. A few old sabers, some rusty muskets. That's all we needed to stop the enemy's advance. Hélas, the tyrant riposted from the heights of the Bastille. His cannons tore us to shreds. I could only flee while my comrades fell as heroes for our nation. What's the point of surviving if you must bend the knee to a bloodthirsty despot?
Monsieur.
Leave me now. I'll soon join my comrades. Leave me, I say. I already have one foot in the...